this video, I will show you how to track your ovulation and your fertile window so you can get pregnant faster. It may come as a surprise to some of us, but there are only 6 days within each menstrual cycle where you can become pregnant. These 6 days are known as your fertile window, where having sexual intercourse may result in a pregnancy. So it makes sense that you must be able to identify your fertile window to know when to have sexual intercourse for even a chance at pregnancy. In this video, I will teach you how to recognize your fertile window so you are having sex when ovulation is approaching, which will increase your chances of trying to conceive. Now, your egg only lives for 24 hours after ovulation, so the sperm needs to find the egg in this 24-hour window in order for fertilization to take place. We are fortunate then that the sperm can live inside our reproductive tract for up to 5 days, which gives the sperm the chance to get into position in your fallopian tubes, waiting for the moment that ovulation happens and that egg is released. So your fertile window is the 5 days before you ovulate and the day of ovulation. And this makes up the 6 days that you are fertile within each menstrual cycle. It makes sense then that learning how to identify when ovulation is approaching is a necessary step to identify your fertile window. We are lucky, of course, that our body shows us signs and symptoms that predict that ovulation is approaching and then ways to confirm that ovulation happened. I know, it's amazing, right? To help this make sense, having a little understanding of your menstrual cycle is really helpful. And to help you understand the menstrual cycle a little bit better, I have this diagram which shows you the hormones and the anatomy of the reproductive system. Now, the purpose of every single menstrual cycle is ovulation, and this is where the egg is released from the ovary every month. You have two phases of your menstrual cycle, which is separated by ovulation. You have the follicular phase, and then you have the luteal phase. Now, the first phase of your menstrual cycle is the follicular phase, which goes from day one of your period until ovulation. And this is where the brain sends out the hormone, follicle stimulating hormone, which is represented by this purple line here. So the follicle stimulating hormone, or FSH, it stimulates the follicles to grow and mature. Now, as they do, they produce estrogen. Now, estrogen levels continue to go up, and when they reach this peak estrogen level, they signal back to the brain, which causes the release of luteinizing hormone, which you can see here by this light blue line. It is the luteinizing hormone that triggers ovulation, and the egg then ruptures from the ovary and collected by the fallopian tubes. And after ovulation, you move into the luteal phase, which is the second phase of your menstrual cycle. So after ovulation, or after the egg is released, this remaining follicle then turns into what is called the corpus luteum. And it is the corpus luteum that goes on to produce estrogen and progesterone in the second half of your menstrual cycle. Now, if pregnancy doesn't happen, the corpus luteum will have a lifespan of around 14 days. So after this 14 days, no pregnancy has occurred, the corpus luteum shuts down, and then estrogen and progesterone levels decline, and then your uterine lining sheds and you see your period. Now, if pregnancy does happen, the fertilized egg will travel down the fallopian tubes into the uterus to be implanted, where it will start making the pregnancy hormone HCG. This then signals back to the corpus luteum, and the corpus luteum will continue to make progesterone and sustain the lining of the uterus. So what's important to know is that after ovulation, or after the egg has been released, your chances of conceiving in the second half of your menstrual cycle are gone, as remember, the egg only lasts for 24 hours after ovulation. So in this video, I am going to help you identify the signs and symptoms your body shows you when you are about to ovulate. This means that you can then time sexual intercourse so the sperm is where it should be in the reproductive tract, waiting in the fallopian tubes for ovulation to happen, which will increase your chances of pregnancy. My favorite sign that your body shows you when ovulation is approaching is your cervical fluid. Now, some call this vaginal mucus or vaginal discharge, or some can call it cervical mucus or cervical discharge. But this fluid is released by your cervix in response to increasing estrogen levels in your follicular phase, which is before ovulation. When estrogen levels are lower, Your cervical fluid will resemble something that is quite sticky and tacky, almost like a clag glue. When estrogen levels go up, the cervical fluid will change to a more lotion consistency, and eventually when estrogen levels peak, you will see the egg white cervical fluid, which is your most fertile cervical fluid. This is how the sperm can live inside your reproductive tract for up to 5 days. It is the cervical fluid that nourishes the sperm and helps the sperm get to where they need to go in your reproductive tract. Without this alkaline cervical fluid, the sperm simply wouldn't survive in the otherwise acidic vaginal environment. And if the topic of cervical fluid is new to you, please check out my previous video, The Types of Cervical Fluid. It gives a demonstration to make it really clear and help you recognize the different types of cervical fluid. But what you need to know for the purposes of this video is that you will only see your cervical fluid in your menstrual cycle when estrogen levels are high without the presence of progesterone. So once you ovulate and progesterone production begins, the cervical fluid will dry up and not be seen until your next follicular phase when estrogen rises again. So remember that you are in your fertile window 5 days before you ovulate. But we can only know for sure that you're in your fertile window once you've ovulated and then count back that 5 days. But we now know that your growing follicles are producing estrogen, and estrogen is producing cervical fluid. As estrogen levels increase, the cervical fluid becomes more fertile, and this is how the sperm survives in your reproductive tract for the 5 days waiting for ovulation to happen. So you can then assume that you are in your fertile window once you see the presence of cervical fluid. Once this cervical fluid changes consistency and looks like that stretchy egg white, you know that you are in your most fertile time in your menstrual cycle. But it is recommended that you start having sex every second day as soon as you see cervical fluid present. And then once you see that stretchy egg white cervical fluid, start having sex daily to increase your chances to fall pregnant. You can also use an ovulation predictor kit to predict when ovulation is about to happen. Now, using an ovulation predictor kit along with cervical fluid tracking can really optimize sexual intercourse timing to increase your chances of falling pregnant. These tests are really similar to pregnancy tests, where you can either pee on a stick or you can dip one of the sticks into a cup of urine, and it tests for when the luteinizing hormone has been released by the brain. And remember back to the menstrual cycle, where estrogen reaches its peak level, and this peak level of estrogen signals back to the brain, causing the release of luteinizing hormone, which will trigger ovulation. So you are testing your urine daily with these kits, waiting for a positive test. It is likely that you will see two lines when cervical fluid is present, but you get a positive LH test when the two lines are equally as dark as one another. Now, as the name suggests, this is an ovulation predictor kit. This doesn't confirm ovulation, it only predicts that ovulation might happen. Most people will ovulate within 24 hours after a positive test, but the time frame of ovulation from a positive test can be anywhere from 6 to 72 hours. It is great to combine the two predictive ways of ovulation because, as we learned earlier, once you have ovulated, your window for trying to conceive is over. Once you see your cervical fluid, we know that estrogen levels are increasing. We also know that once estrogen reaches its peak, it will cause the release of luteinizing hormone. And then at the same time, you are using the LH strips to identify that LH surge, which we know happens prior to ovulation. And this allows you to time sex perfectly to have the sperm in the reproductive tract waiting where they need to be at that very moment of ovulation. So once again, once you start seeing this cervical fluid and two lines appear on the LH strips, you want to be having sex every second day. And then once you see the very fertile egg white cervical fluid and the two lines become equally dark on the LH strips, you want to be having sex daily to optimize your chances for conception and pregnancy. Now, you should start checking for cervical fluid as soon as your period stops. The most accurate way to check for cervical fluid for menstrual cycle tracking and for fertility purposes, it is best to insert your finger at least an inch into your vagina, and then to test for the type of cervical fluid, you rub your fingers together and check for that tactile consistency. And this should be done once your period finishes and until you confirm ovulation. So you want to notice how the cervical fluid feels by rubbing your finger and your thumb together. To test for egg white cervical fluid, press your thumb and your finger together and slowly stretch it out. And if you see an egg white consistency between that thumb and that finger, you can be sure that you are seeing your fertile egg white cervical fluid. And for a more detailed demonstration on all the types of cervical fluid, please check out the previous video as mentioned before. I'll have the link in the description box below. As soon as you see any cervical fluid, it is now time to start using the ovulation predictor kit tests. You only need to test once per day, and it is better to wait until after 10 a.m. So in between 10 a.m. and 2 p.m. because it does take some time for the luteinizing hormone to get from your blood and into your urine. And remember that the LH test strips are testing luteinizing hormone in your urine. And once you see a positive test of two equally dark lines, this is the time that you want to be having sex every single day until you confirm ovulation. And if you don't want to track your cervical fluid and use the ovulation predictor kit tests on their own, you want to start using these test strips from about day 8 or 9 in your menstrual cycle, but that is only, of course, if you have a 28-day menstrual cycle. However, I do find that combining the two strategies will increase your chances, and you are way more in tune with your body and what it's trying to tell you. And some people who use ovulation predictor kits will get varying results. Some will only see negative LH test strips, and some will only see positive LH test strips, no matter where they are in their menstrual cycle. This is often due to their own individual hormone imbalances. This is mostly common in women who have irregular menstrual cycles or long menstrual cycles or no periods at all. If your periods are late or missing, please check out my previous video, 14 Reasons Why Your periods are late or missing. If your LH test strips are inconsistent and your menstrual cycle is very irregular, you can still use cervical fluid as a predictor of ovulation. Every time you see your cervical fluid, you know that your body is trying to ovulate. So this is still the time that you want to have sex to increase your chances of falling pregnant. It just means in long menstrual cycles that you may not ovulate even though your body is trying to, but at a later stage you might. So every time you see that cervical fluid present, that is the time that you want to be having sex to increase your chances of pregnancy. So we've covered the ways that you can predict when ovulation is approaching, and we've discussed when to have sex in order to increase your chances of conceiving. I have mentioned that you have sex every second day as soon as you see cervical fluid present or two lines on the LH test strip. Then when you see your fertile cervical fluid and you get a positive test on the LH test strips, which is two equally dark lines, you then increase the frequency of sexual intercourse to daily until you can confirm ovulation has happened. The way to confirm ovulation is by monitoring your basal body temperature. We know that progesterone will increase your basal body temperature, and we know that once you've ovulated, the corpus luteum will produce progesterone. So once you've ovulated, your whole baseline temperature will shift and increase slightly, and your temperature will stay in this shift for as long as progesterone is being produced. To confirm ovulation, it is important that you see 3 consecutive days of increased temperatures. If you only see 1 day of increased temperature and then it comes back to baseline, there could be something else going on, and we need to assume that you are still in your fertile window. There are downsides to checking your basal body temperature. First of all, you need a specific thermometer, and it is called a basal body thermometer. You also need to check your temperature at the same time every morning with little movement to avoid raising your body temperature. But once you see a temperature shift and you can confirm ovulation happened, the egg has now come and gone and conception is no longer possible for that menstrual cycle. Your fertile window is now finished and you can go back to having sex for fun rather than just trying to make a baby. And the big question is, will tracking your ovulation work for you? If you have regular menstrual cycles, meaning that the length of your menstrual cycle is predictable based on your previous menstrual cycles, then these methods are really useful for identifying your fertile window and then being able to time sex optimally to increase your chances of conception. There are, of course, people who are not ovulating regularly, and for them, they will see late or missed periods. If you have irregular menstrual cycles and you are not ovulating regularly, it can be hard to identify that fertile window and then hard to time sex correctly in order to achieve conception. But I want you to know that it is not impossible to track your fertile window or your ovulation when you have irregular cycles. You just need to know how and be more diligent. That's all. I will cover how to track fertile windows and ovulation in people with irregular cycles in upcoming videos. So if you would like to be notified when I release new videos, please hit that subscribe and notification bell. I cover 14 reasons why your periods could be late or missing in a previous video, and I'll put the link in the description box below. And these may explain why you're not ovulating regularly. Blood tests can be done to help identify the cause of your irregular menstrual cycles. We can then treat that cause and then help you regulate your periods and your menstrual cycles so you can ovulate regularly again, and then you too can identify your fertile window and time sexual intercourse for optimal conception.